Hello, this is another in my continuing series of short Ted Green inspired lessons. This is going to be on the A section of rhythm changes in B flat. If you don't know what rhythm changes or from the George Gershwin song, I Got Rhythm, if you don't know what rhythm changes are, do a Google search of it. This will be far from exhaustive. There's a huge amount of information online if you want every possible chord substitution. This one is relatively straightforward. It is distinctly Ted Green in that it is both traditional and modern at the same time. Chord voicings are, some of them are easy, some of them are intermediate, none of them are what I would call advanced or difficult. I did tweak one or two of the chord shapes to keep it in the intermediate area. I will link to the original Ted Green lesson on the tedgreen.com website, and I will also post a JPEG of how I tweaked it. I wrote it out, and I'm going to hold it up here. Maybe you can take a screenshot of it. Hopefully you can see it. Again, it's in B flat. It's just the A section. I'm going to play through it once, and then we'll talk about it. So, one chord, B flat, two. Talk about each one of those chords. The first chord, or the first two measures, are a 1, 6, 2, 5. And the particular six that I'm, or Ted, is using here is six dominant. So it's not a G minor seventh, it's a G dominant seventh. First chord is just a B flat two chord. It's got the root, the second, and the fifth in there. Third, no major seventh, super simple. G7, sharp 9, sharp 5. C minor 9th, which is a really great voicing if you're into any modern jazzer from Bill Evans to Bill Frisell. Gotta know this chord. And then this F7, sharp 9, sharp 5. You can simplify this. Instead of playing it, you could just do this much of it, which if you'll notice is the same shape as the first chord you played. Or for more bite, the original way. Then the next two bars of the tune, which is 3, 6, 2, 5. D minor, G7 flat 9 sharp 5, C minor 7th, F7 flat 9 sharp 5, then F minor 9 to a B flat 7 sharp 5 flat 9, E flat, and I'm using a little fourth voicing here. You could put the root in there. Flat major to E flat minor 13, and you'll notice that probably to a lot of you looks like an A flat 13th chord. You could do, instead of this E flat to E flat minor, you could go E flat or this E flat major 7th to a really cool A flat 13 flat 5, or A flat 9 flat 5. I wrote that on my page. And then we're going to go a really cool John Coltrane style turnaround. So back to B flat. This time I have the third on the bottom to a D flat 7, G flat major 7th. To a B13 with the third on the bottom to 1. So and that turnaround again. Or, and I wrote this on my page as well, that voicing for a D flat 7, it's a little bit more difficult. G flat major 7th. Time a little quicker all the way through it. And there we have it. If you have any questions, leave one in the comments section, or if it's posted to one of the guitar websites, leave it on the thread. I will be more than happy to answer it. And I will do, if there's interest in this, I will give an example or two of the B section of rhythm changes. Thank you very much.